الحمد لله حمدا طاهرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا وقائدنا ومعلمنا وعظيمنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله الله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز ورشد، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فلا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise him who seek his help, and in him subhanahu wa ta'ala we seek refuge from every evil in ourselves. I give witness that Allah is the one, the only one, the eternal, the absolute. And I give witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and a prophet whom he sent to the truth as a giver of good tidings and a warner before the coming of the hour. Whosoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be rightly guided. And whosoever disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will bring harm to himself and no harm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، دعونا نسترجع الأحداث وما مر ويمر على أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ففيها الدروس والعبر. Let us recall the events as they happened before and what is happening today. For in it, we'll see lessons and wisdoms. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، لقد شكل الغرب بالأمس كتيبة الإعدام وشاركت معه في الجريمة ثمة منظومة عربية نتهمها اليوم بقتل فلسطين والعراق وأفغانستان، جريمة مع سبق الإصرار والترصد. Not that long ago, when the Western governments have composed a brigade for the execution of Palestine, the execution of Iraq, the execution of our Ummah, and the execution of Afghanistan. With them cooperated some assembly of Arabs and the Islamists. Today we accuse them for the killing of Palestine, Iraq, and Afghanistan. A premeditated crime, well planned, well executed. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، كانت المنظومة العربية الإسلامية على موعد مع العار لتمرير إعدام العراق. كانت منها حفنة من الحكام المتصهينين ليحملوا أوزارهم وأوزار من يضلونهم، وكان منها حفنة من علماء السوء ليضفوا الشرعية على الجريمة، وكان منها الكتاب والصحفيين كانت مهمتهم تزوير المجد والتاريخ لصالح تل أبيب وواشنطن. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، the assembly of the Arab and the Islamist organizations, they were at a date with shame in order to pass the execution of Iraq. Amongst them were a squad of rulers, dealers rather. They were more Zionists than the Zionists themselves. in order to carry their sins and the sins of those whom they misguide. And amongst them were a group of corrupted scholars in order to add legitimacy to the crime. And amongst them were a squad of writers and the journalists. Their role was to falsify the glory and the history of our Ummah for the benefit of Tel Aviv and Washington. ولا يغيب عنا ذاك الكم الهائل من الفضائيات التي لا نعرف ما هي مهمتهم في الحياة وكانوا وما زالوا يتراقصون على جراح الأمة واشتغلوا بأمور تجعل الحليم حيران وتجعل المؤمن يندى جبيله من العار. And we cannot forget that great number of satellite channels that we do not know what their function in life. They were and they still dance on the wounds of the Ummah. And they occupy themselves with issues that make you perspire of shame. وكنا نتساءل and we were questioning ourselves ما هذا الذي يحدث what is going on ماذا يعني تغييب الأمة في قنوات فضائية تحمل للعالم المسلم عهره اليود questioning ourselves what is going on what does it mean that these satellite channels bring to the Muslim world the vulgarity and the indecency of Hollywood. إنه لا يندى جبين المؤمن عندما يرى الواقع العربي من المحيط إلى الخارج. Indeed, the free, the believer, perspire of shame when he look at the status of the Arab nations from the ocean to the Gulf. وإذا نظرت إلى السجون والمعتقلات شرقا وغربا تجدها مملوءة بأبناء الإسلام. ولنا أن نحدد على من تقع اللائمة في الانتقال من سياق المجد والتاريخ والعظمة لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى ما نحن فيه من العار من سياق العار في تلك الأيام. Indeed, the believer perspire of shame when you look at the status of the Arab nations from the ocean to the Gulf. And if you look at the jails, the prisons, and the dungeons, left and right, east and west, you find it is full of Muslim people. And we have to define exactly to whom we should put the blame for transferring the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the status of dignity and the greatness to what we have today of shame, status of shame and the surrender. And what a shame on the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be led by people, so-called leaders, dealers like Bin Ali or Mubarak, or هذا المعتوه, the Pharaoh of Libya, who is killing his own people in order to remain in charge after 42 years. Killing his own people, that his own principal job is to protect the people, not to terrorize the people, to terrorizing his own brothers and the sisters. What shame on the Muslim Ummah that the Western world, the Kafir world, ask a Muslim not to kill his brothers and his sisters and to terrorize his own people. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, الكفر اليوم شاهر سيفه. Today atheism and the kufr is raising their sword and they welcome to the age